If you decide a network for a new house, I will suggest you to put a Cat5e or Cat6 Ethernet cable from the router to each of the location you plan to use the network. You may say I can use the Wi-Fi to cover all the area. Yes, but the cable provides much more stable connection than Wi-Fi. It's in some scenario, even you want to put a cable from the router to the Wi-Fi, but there's no enough RJ45 network port from your router. In this video, I'm going to show you how to increase the network port by using a switch. If you want to learn more about the networking, please hit the subscription button and click the little bell. Then you will get notice whenever I release the new video. There are two kinds of network switch. One is the standard network switch. Another is the switch with PoE feature. The major difference is PoE switch not only supply data exchange, but also power over Ethernet. This is the 16-port PoE switch. This switch not only can provide data exchange like the regular switch, it also can supply PoE. So it's quite convenient to use the PoE switch to power some low voltage device such as IP camera, access point, VoIP phone. You only need to put a single cable from the switch to this edge device, and the switch will supply both power and data to this device. There's no need for power source around this low voltage device. Of course, your edge device needs to support PoE. So how to choose? Should we use the PoE switch or non-PoE switch? The one thing you may need to know before you can make the decision. You can use the PoE switch to work with the non-PoE equipment, such as a smart TV, PC computer. Because the standard PoE switch, they have power handshaking. Before this switch send the power to the edge device, it will classify and verify your edge device. If you just connect non-PoE equipment such like the smart TV or the PC computer to one of the PoE port, it will only provide data exchange. So in my opinion, if the little budget is not serious, you can always use the PoE switch to increase the network port in your new house. Okay, now let's move to the demonstration board and just make a quick setup how to use the PoE switch to increase the RJ45 network port. Here I'm using the IP camera for example. Now the camera is live on the monitor. I only need single Ethernet cable to connect this IP camera to the PoE switch. The PoE switch supplies both power and data exchange to this IP camera. It's so convenient, right? There's no need for power source around this camera. Where the cable go, you got both power and data. Now let's take a close look at the switch setup. This is the router. They're only for network port. So I using this 8-port PoE switch, connect to one of these network port. It's very important we don't connect to the last port, WAN port. If we just connect this cable to the last port, it's not going to work because this port is supposed to have the internet from the ISP, but this switch is not able to provide the network accessing. At the bottom, we got the network video recorder. The network video recorder is connecting to one of the PoE port. Like we mentioned, the PoE port will determine whether this device needs power or not. When we connect this device to one of the PoE port, the PoE switch only will provide the data exchange, no power. Let's take a close look at this port. The first port is connecting to a camera. The yellow indicator is on, which means the port number 1 is to provide data and the power. But for the port A, port 9, which linking to the router and the PoE NVR, there's no power port, only provide the data exchange. So when we use the PoE switch, we can connect either the PoE device or non-PoE equipment. That will be fine. It will be smart enough to figure out whether it needs to send the power or not. Here we are using the IP camera. If you want to install the PoE access point, you can reference my another video, how to use the PoE switch to power the access point.